Hello everyone. So my name is Francesco. I work at EPFL Library in the team of research data management, and I will try to convey you the message of how to choose your data repository, trying to do it in 10 minutes, which is kind of a challenge. I get started. So I guess in the next 9 minutes, more or less, I will bring you to more or less know where to start looking for a data repository and what to check when you are selecting one. I will use these two symbols to guide you along. First of all, what is a data repository? Might be a very long definition. Essentially, it's a storage where you can actually preserve your data sets, meaning for the long term, kind of an archive for the long term, but also disseminate your data sets, meaning that you can actually share it. And by data sets, we mean the data and code and whatever is the digital items that you have for your research. With the data repository, you can actually discover other data sets, retrieve them, so download, and reuse them. If you look at the way research is provided, done, like you generate the, let's say, the data, you can process it, then you can actually publish or archive it, but then you can actually want to reuse it, or maybe you want others to reuse it. So in a few words, a data repository is the best you can have for publishing data, archiving them, and reusing them. Where to start looking? Two approaches here. At the extreme, you can actually go for the most used one, at least at EPFL in Switzerland, which is Zenodo. It is a generic data repository. Or you can actually look for data repository, a very specific one for your needs or others. In a search engine, there is a specific one, which is called Retrie Data. I'm going to provide you with a little example later on. Just to make sure, GitHub is not a data repository. EPFL servers are not data repositories. We'll tell you how and why, but the fact is they cannot provide you with a safety net for the long-term preservation that you're actually asking from a data repository. Another place to start looking for a data repository for your research might be to look for the funding agency like the SNSF, which is the Swiss National Science Foundation. They provide a list. In this list, there is Dryad, UDAT, OSF, or Zenodo. Also, the European Commission of Research, they actually provide with a kind of a long list. They list Dataverse, Dryad, EUDAT, Figshare, Zenodo, OSF, and also some domain-specific ones, like the ones that are very specific to a certain research area. So that depends. They might depend on who is going to pay your bills. Of course, there is another way to start looking for data repository, which is ask. You can always ask your colleagues. Maybe there is a data manager in your research group. Maybe you are into a NCCR, so there is a data official. Maybe there is a scientific advisor for your school and department. Or maybe you want to select a data champion and ask him or her. And of course, anytime you can actually send an email to us, to our team, the research data team at dpfl.ch. So once you start looking for a data repository, very nice, but what to look for? What are the perks? What are the features? I will start with the example of Zenodo because it's the most common one. First of all, you can actually explicitly say what is your affiliation. You can look for the communities, and you can actually affiliate your upload, your dataset, to the EPFL community, but there are many EPFL communities on it. You can actually, and these are very specific things that I'm going to list now. The very important one is that you can actually have a DOI, a digital object identifier, which is a persistent identifier, a link that stays there forever. We hope so. You can actually select a publication date, a title, very important, of course, to list the authors. Put a description for making your dataset usable by humans. And the version might be important. You might want to upload just a different version of the same dataset. Keywords are essential because this makes your dataset findable by others. And be sure that your data repository of choice will have some access rights well done. For instance, you can actually choose in Zenodo by open access, embargoed, which is not commonly used, the embargo, restricted access, meaning that others can actually ask to you to have access, and if you don't provide the access, they don't have it, or closed access. You are not providing access to anyone. Once you publish it, in any case, it's much better if you put a license on the dataset, and there is a huge choice of licenses around. Sometimes, I mean, you are, if your research is funded, you probably have a grant, and you are forced, you are asked to put the grant number. And finally, it's not the last thing, but it's one of the most important ones, is that you can actually put a related identifier. What is it? It's a link, for instance, to a paper, to a poster, to the scientific part of your dataset. Maybe it's the code. On the other extreme, you might want to look on retrieved data. You can actually filter by subject, by research area, maybe by country, if you have any sensitive data, for instance, might be useful. Maybe you can select the PID, PID, which is the persistent identifier, like the DOI, and other requirements. In this example, I'm showing you Materials Cloud, which is also developed at EPFL, which is a field specific for computational material, material sciences, chemistry, and physics. They actually make a big deal of being fair compliant, or at least allowing you to be fair compliant by using this data repository. And as you can tell from this example, once you click on research on retrieved data on a specific data repository, you can have information about some general ones, the institution, some terms like licenses and standards, like which persistent identifier is going to be used. Maybe you want to start from a comparison table. Here is one. You will have it with these slides. So what I want to you focus to is the actually the first row. So just look for the discipline, meaning the research area. If it is a generic data repository or a specific one, if it is by a nonprofit or institutional entity, maybe the CERN, maybe a for-profit one like Figshare. The country might be important for one. The cost might also be important, the max value volume that you can actually upload. There are a lot of question marks here. The fact is, many of this information has to be checked data repository by data repository. And we are actually working on a project with a data manager from ENAC and a scientific advisor from engineering faculties to provide to the EPFL community an improved version of this comparison table, of course. Last slide, recommendations. So first of all, or zero of all, baseline, preserve your dataset, select them, not just everything, select your dataset. Select the public. You can actually publish or share your datasets on a generic data repository or a field-specific one, or both. Why not? Just for the peace of mind, be sure that the data repository you are actually going to use is listed on retrieved data and certified. Be sure to have a DOI or any other persistent identifier with it. The cross-linking might be very, very nice to have, because this is a major way to make your research work be found, meaning that you link the dataset with your article or code or poster. Maybe the nonprofit is important because, for instance, the SNSF doesn't reimburse you if you pay for a for-profit one. Make sure to actually attach a good license to the dataset. By good, that depends on your choice, actually, of course, and on your motivations and some requirements from the founders. and be sure that you actually are able to upload whatever you need to be uploaded. This information is not there in RE3 data. It also has to be checked data repository by data repository. So it depends, all depends on your needs, the strategy of your research group, for instance, and the time you want to spend. Last, thank you, everyone. Go and check out the coffee lecture webpage, very interesting ones, after mine, of course, much better. And go and check the research data management RDM webpages with a lot of links to useful resources. And contact me or my team, of course, the team in which I work, anytime you want. Thank you very much.